My name is Walina Semuzuma. Welcome to Sunday School Online Service. We are glad you could join us. We are going to start with a prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you for everything you have given us. We thank you for protecting us. We pray that you protect us throughout this day. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, Amen. So, boys and girls, we're going to start with praise and worship. Join Baweme with today's memory verse.
So today's memory verse is Hebrews 10, verse 25. It says, we should not stop gathering together with other believers, as some of you are doing. Instead, we must continue to gather even more as we see the day of the Lord coming. And that's the end.
Thank you, Baweme. Now, boys and girls, join us for fun time.
It's fun time. Welcome, boys and girls. I'm so glad you could join us. Now, let's get your books, your pencils, your Bibles out because it's time to rake your brains. Okay, so for today, we're having a quiz. A quiz, what? All right, boys and girls, let's get to it. Okay. What are the two greatest commandments that Jesus gave us? What are the two greatest commandments that Jesus gave to us? You have 3 seconds to respond. And time is up. So the greatest commandments that Jesus gave to us is to love God first with all our heart, all our mind, our soul, and all our strength. And the second one is to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. So if you got that correct, congratulations. All right, next, our question is, how do we show God that we love Him? How do we show God that we love Him? 3 seconds to respond. Time is up. All right, so we show God that we love Him by obeying His commandments. Yes, Jesus said, if you love me, then keep my commandments. Our third and final question. Now this one, I don't mind if you get 3 right or if you get 2 right, you can share the answers amongst yourselves. That's okay, because there's a whole list of them. All right, let's go for the third and final question. What is love according to 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4, 5? What is love according to 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 and 5? You have 3 seconds to respond. All right, 3 seconds is up. Okay, so if on your list you have the following, then you are correct. Okay, so love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. Love does not boast. Love is not proud. Love is not rude. Love is not self-seeking. Love is not easily angered. And the final one is love keeps no records of wrong. Okay, so if you got all those right, that's great. And if you got 3 of those right, that's still okay. I'm so glad you could join us for Fun Time. We'll see you next time. God bless you. Bye.
It's lesson time with Auntie Tama.
Good morning, boys and girls. We are so glad you could join us for today's lesson. I am Teacher Tama, or Auntie Tam Tam, whichever you're comfortable with calling me. Okay, before we go far, I'd like us to close our eyes and pray. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you so much for today. I thank you so much for everyone who's watching us from wherever they are. I just ask, Holy Spirit, that you give them understanding of your word, even as we get into scripture and learn more about who you are, who we are in you, oh God, and our purpose for our lives. And I pray, Holy Spirit, that you bring everyone closer to your heart in Jesus' name, as you teach us to love you and to love your commands. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Now let's get into it. I'm excited for today's lesson because, well, it's really, really important. So I hope that you are ready for today's lesson. Grab a pen, a pencil, a book, and a paper, and have your Bible nearby because we're going to look into God's Word. Okay, so today's lesson title is fellowship. Fellowship, okay? And this is a word that we use so many times, and maybe some of you, this is the first time you're hearing about it, the word fellowship. But don't worry, I'm going to explain to you what it means. We're also going to look at the importance of fellowship, okay, and who we should be fellowshipping with and why it's important to fellowship with them. All right, so let's jump right into it, okay? So, like I said, we're going to learn and understand what fellowship is and also how to fellowship with God and fellow believers or Christians and the importance of fellowship, okay? So our anchor scripture for today is coming from the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse 42 to 47. Okay, so turn your Bibles to Acts chapter number 2, verse 42 to 47. And I'm going to read for us, okay? I hope you turned, have you gotten there? I hope you've turned to the book of Acts. It's in the New Testament, if you're wondering. Okay. All right. So Acts chapter 2, verse 42 to 47 reads, "They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to fellowship, to the breaking of bread and to prayer. Everyone was filled with awe at the many wonders and signs performed by the apostles. All the believers were together and had everything in common.
They sold property and possessions to give to anyone who had need. Every day, they continued to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their homes and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. And the Lord added to their number daily those who were being saved. This is really, really interesting. So here we're just being told about how the apostles, back in Jesus' time, gave what they owned. Okay, some people had land, some people had houses, some people had cattle, the sheep, and they sold those things because they used to fellowship together, and as they fellowshiped together, they began to see that there are some people who didn't have food, some people didn't have places to live, and so they sold their land, or they gave their land away so that they were able to help their friends. And so now let's get into what the word fellowship means, okay, before we go too far. Okay, so the word fellowship comes from the Greek language, which in the Greek language it's called koinonia, and it simply means having something in common, okay? Having something in common. So you and me can have something in common, and when we meet together, it's what we call fellowship, okay? So you can have something in common with your neighbor because you stay in the same area, so that's what's common. That's common between you and your neighbor. You might be the same age, and some of you might be in the same grade, and so that is what is common with you and your neighbor, or you and your classmate. You might be at the same school and the same class, and you have the same teachers. So your teacher, your class, and the grade, and sometimes even your age, are the things that are in common. And so you get to hang out together, you get to play together, and that is called fellowship. And for Christians, we fellowship, or we can call it fellowship, because one, we pray and worship the same God. We might go to the same church, okay? And sometimes maybe we can be in the choir together or Sunday school together. And when we come together, that is called fellowship, all right? So fellowship is really just having something in common. And these things are the things that I've mentioned. It can be your age, it can be the church that you go to, and the same God that you pray to. So we are in fellowship. All right. Okay, so now that we've understood what fellowship is, okay, now let's get to a place where we understand how we can fellowship with God and with other people or other Christians. Okay, so in Acts chapter 2 and verse 42 to 47, we saw how the apostles came together because they're the church. They came together and they shared things. They ate together. They sold land so that they were able to help their brothers and their sisters who were in need. Okay, so that's one way that they did fellowship a long time ago. They would meet in someone's house, or maybe under a tree, and they'll come together, have a meal together, and that was fellowship for them. And fellowship for us today is we come together on a Sunday, okay, and we meet our friends, maybe in the same, we might be in the same Sunday school class, or maybe we meet in church, and we get to praise God together, and that's fellowship also. Okay, so we are fellowshipping with our friends and our family. Now, fellowship also happens on a higher level, which is fellowship with human beings and God. Okay, so God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to die for our sins, and also He raised He was raised from the grave, so he's no longer dead, he's alive, okay? And he left us the Holy Spirit, who helps us in living the way he wants us to live, a holy life, okay? And so because of that, because of Jesus' death and resurrection, we people have the opportunity to fellowship with God, okay? We have a chance to fellowship with God, okay? Other than just fellowshipping with people, we have a chance and an opportunity to fellowship with God. And how does this fellowship come about? You'd have to accept Jesus in your heart and in your life so that he becomes your forever friend. And that's how that beautiful fellowship begins with him, all right? And now we'll look at the importance of fellowship, because it's important to understand why certain things should happen, okay? As if you look back at the story and the scripture that we read about the apostles back in the day and how they were able to know that someone needed something, that's because they came together, and as they prayed together and they ate together, they began to see that there are some brothers and sisters who didn't have food or a place to stay. So fellowship, the importance of fellowship is to strengthen us, first of all, as believers. When we come together and worship God, and when we come together and meet because we want to share a meal or maybe want to pray together, read the Bible together, God shows us the things that we need in our lives. So sometimes you might be feeling sad and you might be feeling alone and lonely, but because you have people that you come together with and fellowship with them, God provides you with company when you're feeling lonely. He provides you with a friend to help you feel happy, okay? And also, fellowship is important because we get support from that, okay? You might need help in how to read the Bible or study at school, and you get that kind of support from a friend because you fellowship with them, okay? And so you get that support. They get to help you in your school. They get to help you understand God's word a little better. We also get united through fellowship, okay? As we continue to meet together, as we continue to have meals together, we continue to pray together, we get closer together, and that makes us united. And so that is a very, very powerful thing that God does, and that God has allowed for us as human beings to come together so that we may be strengthened through fellowship, so that we may be supported through fellowship, and so that we may be united through fellowship. And so that's why fellowship is very important. And speaking of unity, when we are born, boys and girls, we are not united with Christ, okay? Because of sin, because we keep on missing the mark that God has set for us. But Jesus came so that we can meet that mark through him, okay? And through him also, we can have fellowship with God the Father. And so, boys and girls, I'm also inviting you, if you haven't accepted Jesus in your life, so that if you haven't accepted Jesus in your life, that you accept him today, that you may have a unity, a unitedness with Christ and God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. It's the kind of unity that can never be replaced by any kind of unity. And you get support from God himself. You have strength from him like no other. Okay, so boys and girls, I invite you today to just come to a place where we accept Jesus as our forever friend. And how do you do that? I'm going to help you in a moment. Okay, so let's just go through what our lesson was about. So we talked about fellowship, right? So fellowship, we've described it as having something in common. And it can be if you're looking at your friends, the friends around you, you have something in common with them, and that's why you get to hang out with them, you play with them. Okay? It can be that you're in the same area with them, you're at the same school, and you could be at the same grade. Okay? Another thing is the importance of fellowship. We've said that it gives us strength, it gives us unity as people of God, and it also provides us with support. We get support from other people because we can't do life alone. No one is an island, okay? Nobody can stay or live alone and be happy. You need people around you, and that's why God created and allowed for us to come together and have fellowship, okay? And another thing is we've also learned that we can fellowship together with people and God by going to the same church, praying together, and reading God's word, the Bible, together, okay? So now for my friends who don't know Jesus and would like to be in fellowship with him so that he gives them strength and he gives them support and he unites us with God, here's a prayer that you can pray so that you can have a friendship relationship with Jesus, and he'll be forever your friend. Okay, just pray with me now. Dear Lord Jesus, I thank you so much for my life. I thank you that you care and you love me so much. I realize that I have done wrong in your eyes and I've sinned against you because you alone are God. Right now I ask that you come into my heart. I invite you to be my forever friend. And I ask that you help me to live according to your word in Jesus' holy name. Thank you so much for what you did on the cross. You took the punishment on my behalf so that I may not be punished, and so that I can also be united with you in Christ Jesus. I thank you so much, and I invite you to be my Lord and my Savior, today and forever. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen and amen. Now, boys and girls, if you prayed that prayer, I would like to be the second one to invite you into the kingdom of God, because heaven already is throwing a party for you. Okay, and they're welcome. You are welcome in the kingdom of God, and you become a kingdom kid. And just tell your mom, your dad, your cousin, whoever is around you, that you have accepted Jesus as your forever friend. And so you are in fellowship with God, and he will give you strength and he will support you, and you are united in him. All right. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see you next time. God bless you.
Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time. Bye. Okay.